August 14th, 2012. Yes, I know about the August 10th post that Frederick has quote-unquote made, but I'm not sure if he's still alive or if one of his followers is acting as him. Either he or the follower used another keylogger, or he went on my blog when I was asleep again, which is unlikely. Today, I got Happy's birthday from the person who keeps sending me the videos. Happy's birthday starts out with Happy Appy talking to the camera saying, "Hey kids, it's my birthday today. I'm 32. And a kid says, "Happy birthday, Happy. Want to open your presents?" Happy does a death smile and says, "Sure." Happy Appy is seen in an arcade, at a table decorated for his birthday, with a truckload of presents. The kids are handing the presents. During this scene, you can see the smoking ruins of the ice cream parlor. Happy excuses himself from the table. He talks to the camera outside, saying, "What those kids don't know is that I contributed all but a few of the presents, and they're all things I can use with my friends to help the children." Doesn't that sound swell? Happy goes back into the arcade and opens a package, which had a knife in it. He sets it on the table, and a kid picks it up and swings it, knocking the cake off the table. Happy gets pissed off, so he says, "Hey kids, Billy and I are gonna go get another cake." Happy grabs Billy's hand and runs with him outside. Happy, Appy, and Billy run into the van, which was repaired for the most part. A few remnants of the ice cream truck can be seen, however. Happy gets a chainsaw and tries to mutilate Billy. Billy is heard screaming, and a guy who was drinking some soda goes over to the van. He opens the door, and Happy jams the chainsaw into the man's face, tearing it open. Happy drags the body of the guy in and kills Billy. A few minutes later, Happy goes back to his birthday party and opens the rest of his presents. Happy says, "Who wants cake and ice cream?" And all the children yell, "Me!" Happy goes to his van and gets a marble cake with apples on it, and puts it on the table. He lights the candles, and the kids sing him happy birthday. Happy starts cutting slices of the cake and gives them to the children. The children nearly eat the cake when one kid says, "Happy, what's the filling of this cake?" Happy worriedly says, "Strawberry." And the child displays the marble cake of what looks like blood between the layers. It looked more like real strawberry filling, however. Happy says, "Children, give me a moment. Don't eat your cake just yet." He runs off with the kid that asked him what the filling was. Happy hesitantly says, "If you don't mention what the filling of the cake could be anymore, I'll let you play with some arcade games." After this, he then brings out 10 rolls of quarters. The kid takes the rolls of quarters and runs off. For a minute, the kid plays the various games in the arcade. He goes outside and finds a photo booth named Lenny Lemon's Photos. He goes into the booth and shuts the curtain. After pressing a few on-screen buttons, the kid is ready to take his photo, when Happy Appy jumps out from the back and strangles him. Happy had set up his van to look like a photo booth. The booth begins to break apart, revealing Happy's van. The kid is heard screaming, and mutilation noises can be heard. The door slides open to show Happy doing his death smile, with body parts and blood everywhere. Happy goes back into the party room and says, "Now you can eat the cake." The kids eat their cakes and start to throw up. Happy Appy begins to smile as the kids keep puking until they fall unconscious. He drags all the children to his van and drove off. A long driving scene happens, with Happy nearly falling asleep at the wheel, and Happy parks his van in his house. He drags the kids into his basement, and for the rest of the episode until the credits, he does that damn smile. The credits had no music, just heavy breathing by someone in a mask. It showed the promo for the next episode, Danny Returns. All it shows is a monologue by an older Danny explaining what Happy did many years ago, off-screen. Happy says, "Hey Danny," and the promo ends abruptly. August 15th, 2012. Today I got a letter from the Otis Lens Factory, once famous for producing high-quality furniture. For whatever reason, the envelope was heavily wrinkled and moldy, like it was stored in a safe for 100 years. After opening it, I found an undated letter, telling me that my presence was required at the factory. Clearly I had suspicions about this letter, so I researched the factory's history. It turns out that the Otis Lens Factory shut down in 1997 due to a fire, so either the letter was delivered extremely late, or one of Frederick's helpers is trying to lure me so that he or she could kill me. August 17th, 2012. I went to the Otis Lens Factory yesterday. Ever since the fire, it has become a very popular target for urban exploration in Aberdeen. Most of what remained inside the factory was stolen, save for the machines that made the furniture. After parking in what remained of the parking lot, I went inside the factory with a revolver and a flashlight. As soon as I said, "Is anyone there?" I caught a glimpse of someone in a chair. I pointed my flashlight and instantly knew who was in the chair. It was Tristan Mike Drews. Unlike the bodies of Kevin, Creston, and Miranda, his body wasn't horribly disfigured, since the only visible knife mark was a deep one in his throat. In his hand was a CD, which meant one of two things. It was or wasn't a leaked episode. I took the CD, but I heard "Saw Two Red Eyes" and "Giddy Laughter" in the distance. I didn't feel like fighting one of the followers today, so I got out of the factory and drove home. While driving off, I saw at least three more followers staring at me like they were the village of the damned. After getting home, I put the CD in a laptop that I had reformatted in case the disc held a virus. It was full of 100 or so notepad files and a video. All of the notepad files were just gibberish, but the video was very interesting. It was about 66 minutes long, named Happy Appy Episode Creation 2.wmv. It starts with the forensic mask staring at the camera for about 15 minutes. It turns to static for a minute, and Happy Appy is seen lying on the mask, with his death smile. After the minutes, the camera falls to the floor, and an unknown man can barely be seen in another room. He picks up the camera and holds it to his face and says, "Hello there, I'm Frederick Gorgote, the owner of my little group. Today I'm going to show you how we're making the newest episode, Danny Returns." He goes into a basement, which is massive, and holds several blue screen sets. In the middle, a man is tied up in a chair, with duct tape on his mouth. He walks up to him and removes the duct tape. Frederick says, "This nice man here is Ray Bulia. Or Danny, if you prefer." Danny says, "I hope you all burn in hell. One day you will pay for what you did to my sister, father, and mother." Frederick says, "Oh, I'll die one day, but not before you do," and puts the duct tape back on. Danny, in a muffled voice, starts screaming in anger. Frederick says, "Ignore that pathetic man. Anyways, it begins with writing the script," and points the camera towards a typewriter with some paper in. Frederick says, "Just for you, I'll show you the name of the episode after Danny returns," and zooms the camera in towards the title, which was A Day at the Tracks. Frederick says, "I'm not saying what the episode is about, but I will say that it will be the best episode yet until the one after that is made." He says, "After the script is done, I get the props necessary for the episode, and a table full of props is shown." He says, "I make the props myself, while a few of my followers get the parts. After I make the props needed, I get the cast, if you insist." At the back, some kids are heard screaming, and Frederick walks to the back, and a cage with some malnourished children comes into view. At the 30-minute mark, Frederick says, "These are the cast. Other than Happy, and whoever is playing forensic, after we get the kids, we start filming the episode. I'm on a scene with Danny and Happy. A follower unties Danny, and he tries to strangulate the follower. Frederick grabs his scimitar knife and stabs Danny in the shoulder. He screams, but tries to strangle the follower again. Frederick grabs the knife and begins twisting it to the left. Danny finally gives in, and Frederick drags him over to the blue screen set. Frederick readies the camera and says, "Action!" and begins filming the scene. Danny walks in frame, holding his bloodied shoulder, with Happy's clay model being held up close to the camera. Danny pretends to bump into Happy, and Danny gasps. He instantly says, "You, it's been a long time, hasn't it?" Happy says, "Yes, yes it has. I've always wanted to kill you, since you tried to kill me by blowing the blue barn up." Danny reaches into his pocket and says, "Yes, yes," and brandishes a knife. Frederick says, "Cut," and turns to the camera. He says, "I can't show you anymore. You'll just have to watch the episode to find out if Danny dies, Happy Appy dies, or neither of them gets killed." It goes to static for the rest of the video, but during some parts, I heard the sounds of what seemed like a murder. I'm absolutely horrified at this. I mean, it was already bad when Frederick slaughtered kids back in 2001, but this is just too much. For one, Frederick Gorgote has friends this time around that can help him produce the episodes faster. And second, he's treating the kids as well as Danny worse than before. I am definitely going to stop the followers by the end of the year. August 20th, 2012. So I looked at the hanging clip in Happy the Pirate and found out that the woman who was being hung was actually Jenny from Season 2. How do I know this? Because I found the full 10-minute video of her being murdered on a private live-leaked video. It's the same VHS quality as Happy the Pirate. The video was sickening because after she's knocked out and hung by her legs on a pole, Frederick makes a long speech about how insignificant death and women are, while all the followers listen. After the speech, her body gets set on fire, and she wakes up. She screams in agony for a few minutes until she finally dies. One of the followers puts out the fire on her body, and cuts her head off with Frederick's knife. Finally, they all cut her head open, and eat parts of her brain. This goes on for a couple of minutes, but it felt like an hour. The entire thing looks like a cult gathering, and everything about the video is just awful. I really need to stop this thing before it progresses to the point where my entire family is dead. Also, I heard that Newport was promoted to the rank of sergeant. Good for him.